Hi, my name's Lotte Latukefu. I'm a mezzo-soprano. When I was about halfway through my degree at the Canberra School of Music, I had just decided that what I wanted to do was to go to New York and I wanted to study and I wanted possibly to become a famous opera singer in New York. I wasn't sure that that was exactly what was going to happen to me. I just knew that I wanted to get to New York. I was one of two mezzo-sopranos, at the Canberra School of Music. So that's not exactly a huge amount of competition. The other mezzo-soprano was fantastic. Then when I went up to the Queensland Conservatorium, I was one of about six mezzo-sopranos. When I finally got to the Manhattan School of Music, I was one of about 40 mezzo-sopranos in my year. So to have competed at a national level with a lot of other mezzo-sopranos and have gotten through gave me a real confidence that I could hold my own in New York, you know, the Big Apple, all that sort of thing. When I came back to Australia, I managed to get an agent. I did a lot of work with Andrew McKinnon, and he had a lot of international acts coming out at that time to do festivals. So I worked with a Spanish company who did La Vida Breve. We did Carmen Jones, Porgy and Bess, Kiss Me Kate up at the Brisbane Festival. I was also doing a lot of oratorio work and getting myself ready to audition for the Australian Opera. In the meantime, I just happened to be looking at the paper and noticed an ad for a singing teacher at the University of Wollongong, and it was a part-time position, so they wanted someone who would continue as a singer but also teach half-time at the university. So I decided to apply for that job because actually one of my other passions, real passions, has been always teaching singing. Even as a student, I taught singing. I have always been incredibly interested in vocal technique, in performance, in how people perform. So for me to be able to teach half-time at a university and get some really interesting singing students was just an opportunity that I couldn't pass up. 2004 was the last big opera that I was involved in, and that was down in Adelaide with the fantastic Ring Cycle. And since 2004, what I have really dedicated myself to is practice-led research, where I go out of my way to learn really difficult pieces for composers as a way also to work through some of the questions that I'm interested in to do with performance, to build up a canon of Australian songs that are influenced by Asia and the Pacific, and which at the moment is not, there's not a huge amount of works available that have that sort of influence.